Well, it is Monday night, and officially the holiday is over for me. Got to get ready to go to work tomorrow again, and unfortunately, the next holiday that I get, the actual, like, day off holiday, is not till like, May, I think. So what is that? That's February, March, April. So it's like 3 months of, like, no holidays, which kind of sucks. But I'm not complaining. Today was nice. Woke up late. I think I woke up at 11, which I haven't done that in a while. Had a great time last night. For those of you up in the upper corner up there, you can see my Instagram. If you follow my Instagram, you can see what I did last night. Celebrated my 8-year reunion. It was actually Tuesday, but I'm not going to celebrate that on a Tuesday, especially when I have to work the next day. So we decided to do it on Sunday, especially since I have work today. And went to have some great, there's this place called Akai Hana here in Columbus. It's a great sushi place. Pretty expensive. I think I paid like $120 or something like that. But we enjoyed it. Had the boat for two or three, and the boat is basically just a bunch of nigiri, like rolls, salmon, tuna, very good stuff. So we ate that and then had the wonderful time of listening to the Hoodoo Soul Band, which I've talked about on here before. The greatest band in Columbus, Ohio, and I would even say maybe the Midwest. They just are so awesome and breathe life into me, the kind of music they play and how well they play it. So did that last night, and it snowed a butt ton. So it started snowing at like 6 o'clock, and I think we got probably a good 4 or 5 inches here in Columbus, at least where I'm at. And so right before this, I literally was running because I went to the gym. After the gym in Columbus, just I don't know, I'm sure part of it is because we don't have as many workers and people are just not working, but they literally did nothing to the roads. It's like, where are the trucks? The trucks are not doing anything because the roads are still as bad as they were last night. So I came home, ran in after that. I had to shovel the driveway in the back. We have like a back patio. I had to do that for the dogs. So I literally got done like 5-10 minutes ago. So I like ran in here, changed, and here we are. So welcome back. We've got 10 people, it looks like, in the chat. We've got the regulars, Ryan, Michael. Welcome back, Michael. John, who said it is tonight. Scott's here. Pear is here. Arrow's here. What's up, Arrow? It's nice to see you kind of becoming more consistent around here. I like it. I need a fellow Dream Theater backup to back me up when other people don't like him as much. So, one thing we got to say before we get started on John's set. John has 6 songs, by the way. So we have a bigger set than we did yesterday. Yesterday's set was shorter because there was only 1 song, but that 1 song was 25 minutes. To which Para was there for like 5 minutes, and then he left again, which is pretty common for him to do. Maybe he'll stick around for a long time tonight, since he doesn't have to work tomorrow, it seems. But besides the fact that Colin's set did not get blocked, which is hooray, 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 if you go back to that video from yesterday, it appears that Dean, who is the bald guy in the video for Terramaze, watched the video, so that's good. And he commented on the below and said like something like, I can't remember exactly, just something short, but it means he watched it and he commented. So that's really, really cool. So Dean, if you're watching any, I doubt you're watching this because Terramaze is not going to be going today. But Dean, if you happen to watch this again, thanks for commenting and watching. And that song was pretty killer up until like the 15-minute mark. So, yeah, looking forward to seeing what we've got tonight. Just a quick shout out over here. For those of you who have not noticed, there is a new pay tier list. So make sure that you guys check that out. If you are going to ask me a question and you add an extra dollar to it, make sure in the email that you send me, you ask me the question and make sure you tell me that you added a question or a dollar. $3 for a shot, $7 per song, and then if you're going to do an album, as long as it's around 60 minutes, $50 will get you that. So let's see if any, I'm actually interested if anybody in the next year will do a full album, because I know there have been a couple requests for it, and I think for greater context, a lot of people will say, oh, unless you hear the whole album, you don't really understand it. Terramaze being one of them. So maybe that'll happen. And getting the better, bigger context will make it a little bit better of a reaction. So, all right, Mr. John Feedy, what's up, Wet Feet? It is time for us to jump into your set. And this is what John says. He says, welcome back, because yes, it is a new year. He says, new year, new chances. Here is a collection of songs by bands who I think, i.e. John, deserve another shake here on the channel. Some were downright misses, others were just okay. In either case, some of these bands are making a New Year's resolution for redemption. Capital letters, redemption. And what better way than some double plays? By the end of this set, with luck, all of these bands will be sitting at 2 out of 3 for you. Or they will be 1 out of 3 or 0 out of 3. But let's think positively and say that won't happen. I noted 2 songs that will likely need the filter. Oh, okay. I didn't see that till now. At any rate, hopefully someone hears something they like. So here we go. Fair to Midland is the band, and the song is called Walls of Jericho. Starting off with some Fair to Midland, I had to listen to Kayla Cries Cologne by them, and for the most part, it seemed like a complete miss. So I offer this one. It is from the same album. I specifically didn't do a lyric version because the lyrics were a distraction on Kayla. This particular song is a top 3 Fair to Midland song in my book, says John. This is Walls of Jericho by Fair to Midland. Okay, short and sweet. Let's see. Walls of Jericho is very biblical. So let's see if we like it. And this is a second chance at this band. Here we go. Okay. Like the beginning.
Splendidly we from an atom bomb, retrieve from a teleprom.
What's up, Wade?
You are not. Break the ice with a cotton swab, a fever that cools us all, and shakes a contact sport. No one was waiting to throw out the pilot.
Hey, what's up, Flea? Welcome.
Who is that you know the time?
No gray, Mr. Gray, but what's up, Baggins? Welcome. Yeah, if these guys are Australian, it's no wonder I like them.
Grab my hand, here comes the crash. I live for the strong impact. There it is.
We've got a home base, and I like that.
Takes every letter you send, don't
and that is so John. Feedy, you just love that.
No one was waiting to throw.
Very, Idola-ish.
Tough
note, but I think maybe you should go in head voice for that one. Like that. See, that sounds pretty. You should have done that with the other one. But I know you want to belt it.
You recognize your next door neighbor today.
Love this. I like that almost delay. Sounds similar to the
way. A song that stops the silence. String up your heart. Play like today will last 5 minutes. This won't take long.
Nice build.
Sing us a song that stops the silence. Another song.
got that hoppy edge to it. Like that note. I know you want to sing full voice there, but it should be in head voice. Like that. Shit, is that the end? Wow. That was pretty short, sweet, and that's why I like it. Mr. John Feedy is like notorious for picking good songs that aren't necessarily 20 minutes long. And I liked it. So yeah, that was definitely kind of right down the middle, Mr. Feedy, for your kind of set lists. That was a great redemption for this band because I liked it. It had a nice verse, nice chorus, nice verse, nice chorus. The only kind of negative thing, which I wouldn't even call it negative, was what I said, and that is, when he hits that, like that, da, 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 that's pretty and it's nice. But then when he's like, it's like, he should go into head voice there. I know he's trying to hit that note full voice, but yeah, he should hit that. He's not Mr. Gray. He's not a Einar. So what are you going to do? Not many people are. But other than that, that was great. Okay, let's get into number two, baby. And guess who it is? It's Fair to Midland again. So I'm excited because I like that song. If it's anything like that again, I'm going to be down. This is called Musical Chairs by Fair to Midland. It says second Fair to Midland track, this time from their second album. This one starts and ends on a very small patch of rough scream growl, but then goes melodic through the rest until the very end when the same rough scream growl hits again. This is Musical Chairs by Fair to Midland. Okay, you're being very short and sweet with your descriptions there, Mr. Feedy. All right, here we go. Number two. Jason, I'm glad we can disagree. That's the beauty of this channel. But you're right. Nice. God, I didn't mind that. Bass sounds really weird, but he's kicking ass. Like Scott Untethered Angel, that's a Dream Theater song. Do. I like that. In my head now. Dude, we got two short songs from Feedy. Did I just stop it? Was there more? I just heard a piano going. Was there more, Feedy? Did I just cut it off? Do I need to go back? I just remember you said at the end it's the that was all? Okay. Whew. I was like, shit. I hope I didn't just like stop it after there's like 5 more minutes into the song. Yeah, two short and sweet songs. I like the poppy choruses that they have. It's like very catchy and it's going to be in my head, which is nice. You just like keep that in your head and that's how you get people coming back for more. So right now, Feedy, you're 2 for 2 for me. That band, to be honest, I don't even remember the other song. So if I didn't like the other song, I definitely like these two. So in that case, there are redemption there, I guess. So here we go. Oh, he says, now we go left. Okay. Let's see what happens. Oh, we have had this band on here a couple times. This is Osaka Punch. I have a couple of their songs on my playlist, so I don't know why you think they need redemption. This one's called Spider and the Fly. Back to some Osaka Punch, I think the song I sent by them, Drones, missed for a few reasons. One, I think is the lead singer style in a lot of their songs to do sections of spoken lyrics. Okay. This particular song does not really have that so much, but I personally love the energy in this song and the chorus. This is Spider and the Fly by Osaka Punch. Dude, I had like 2 of their songs on my playlist, so maybe you're not talking about me, but we'll see. Spider and the Fly. Here we go. You're a fly. Sounds like Flight of the Wounded Bumblebee.
I got far too many eyes not to catch you up in your lies. So the fly back to the spider.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I have a couple of Osaka Punch songs on my playlist.
Keep on flying until it dies.
I like that.
I don't care how and or why. I'm gonna make you pay for your crimes.
Is that a girl singer that's backing him up?
Better string your net up higher. I will keep on flying until I die.
Ooh, I like that. It's like this, the box sound on the guitar.
Oh, flee. So the spider to the fly. I got fly.
Are you John? Are you another John? Do you have a set next to
the fly? Back to the spider.
Also John.
Open your mind up wider. Cause this fly will keep on flying until. till it dies. Let's fly, oh, keep on flying. It will keep on flying. Let's fly, oh, keep on flying until it dies. Let's fly, oh, keep on flying.
Halftime is life, Baggins. Exactly. Thank you.
Let's fly, oh, keep on flying until it dies.
Baggins has got it. I'm looking forward to your set, man. Other harmony? Is that a girl? Sounds like a girl to me. I guess it could be a guy. That bass part is cool. Ooh. Like a girl. Wow. Well, whoever is singing the harmony sounds very girly. Not so much here, but in the beginning. Ooh, nice little double there. This song's going on a playlist as well. You're 3 for 3 in my book, Johnny. Johnny Utah. Tell me what movie that's from.
I got an itty bitty little spider crawling up my leg. I don't know what to do. Should
hey, Scott,
away,
that is not a fly, dig. That's a, that could be a compliment. Dissonance there. Thank you, Arrow. Arrow is on the mark, baby. All right, Mr. Johnny Utah, you are 3 for 3 in my book. 3 for 3. All three of these songs are going on playlists, so that's nice because my playlist is getting fucking bigger. So very interesting side note I want to talk about here because I've bitched about it many times on this channel, and that is Spotify. And why the fuck Spotify doesn't have a random player, because I put it on random and it doesn't fucking play random. And I was talking to my programming buddy Noel about it, and he was actually saying, well, because he doesn't use Spotify, he was like, maybe it actually is truly random and that's the problem. Is because, you know, technically speaking, if you have something on random, it would be possible to hear the same song over and over again. He said maybe it's AI or something like that, because like the way we're used to hearing random is that it picks, it like basically puts it in an order and then it doesn't repeat a song until you have listened to that whole list. So you're not going to get the same song twice, which I think we're all accustomed to and used to when it comes to random play. But he was saying that's not truly random, which I never even thought about that. So I wish Spotify, so I'm going to correct myself, I wish Spotify would go back to the old iPod way of random play, because it seems like many times I just, there's like tons of songs on my playlist that I never hear. I just never hear them. And it's like, it seems like the same songs over and over again pop up in the same place. So fuck Spotify. Yes, exactly, JBB. Spotify pisses me off, but again, which is a very smart marketing tool, since all my stuff is on there and I have a bunch of playlists from Spotify, like to change now was like when I had to change from Apple to not Apple, because all the playlists didn't stick and stuff like that, and there was problems and they fucking blocked shit and they put like, oh, it was so annoying. So it's kind of like, I'm in, you know, they've got me, I'm in. I hate Spotify. And I wish there was a way, because they said there is a way to like download the songs that are not on Spotify, because there's still a lot of songs that I search for that are not on Spotify so that I can have them, but I tried to do that and it didn't work. So I have a bunch of songs that I downloaded and I try to get Spotify to download so that I could have them in the playlist so that when I'm not connected to my computer, it would still play those songs. But nope, no luck because Spotify's bullshit. All right, enough of that rant. You are 3 for 3, Mr. John, sir. Let's go to the next one, number 4. This is The Contortionist, which we have heard and had on this channel before. Oh, wait a minute. No, I skipped one. We have Osaka Punch again. That's why I skipped it. This one's called Make the Call. Second Osaka Punch track. Sorry I ruined the next track for you guys. At least you know what's coming. This track, again, has less of the spoken word style while retaining the singer's great soulful delivery. This video is a bit weird because there are only official videos, hence the filter need warning. So I gotta put a filter on this. There is a 15-second intro that isn't the song and a small 10-second outro that is also not the song. But it was the best I could find. So filter up. That'll give me some time to filter up. This is Make the Call by Osaka Punch. So here we go. Let me put the filter on while we do it. This is number 4. So here we go. Fucking like that.
Change in a minute. Well, you got to know right now. Are you
sounds like Jamiroquai when he stepped in.
Simply sit back and watch that slippery little motherfucker slip away.
Ooh, that's gorgeous, yo. I just fucking turned in to Jesse from Breaking Bad because that was so gorgeous. More Osaka Punch songs going on my playlist for show.
How hot is that guitar?
Bitch. That was probably the last 10 seconds he said wasn't a part of the song. All right, Feedy. Once again, you and fucking Adrian, man. You guys just pick all the songs that I like. Especially when you say, oh, it's not going to be that good. People are not going to like it. And then I fucking love every song. You are now 4-for-4, sir. Going on a playlist, not much else to say. Everyone in the chat, I think, likes it too. So I think you're single-handedly helping people like Osaka Punch a bit. So nice work. All right. So everybody knows the band. And now because Paravarium somehow is probably tripping balls, he kind of figured out what the song was too. This is called Reimagined by Contortionist. And it says filter is needed. So I'm going to have to put the filter on this one too. The Contortionist. So far, these guys seem to be 1-for-2. So here is a third song. Hopefully after this one, they will be 2-for-3. This song is relatively straightforward as far as this band goes, but it is really catchy and hooky to my ear. I think it was the song that stuck in my head and brought me back to them. Again, this official video is the only decent one I could find, so filter up. This is Reimagined by Contortionist. All right, so let me filter it up as soon as we start. Booyah. Oh, I've already got it filtered. Sweet. That kind of worked out.
When I found the point of life,
okay,
you came creeping towards me in the shape of.
Yep, I did, because I did some Jacob Collier reactions. Good memory, Para. Your brain cells aren't weeded out. No pun intended. Yeah. Yeah, I like the vibe going on here so far. Lower tempo, 3, 4, 1. I didn't see them live, Michael, just for clarification. I saw the video. Whether that's true or not, there are a lot of people who are so high that they seem stupid. I've met several. The chill vibe of this song. I love it. That's a great logical conclusion, right?
Once you found the breath you lost, breathe again.
added beat there. I sure like this song, so depends on how long it is. I didn't remember how long you said it was.
And I am exactly what you imagined me to be.
I'm exactly what you reimagined me to be? Or imagined me to be? Is that it? Short and sweet once again. Holy shit, we are already through 5 songs and we're at 40 minutes. Love it, John. Love it. Like I said, you pick good songs and they don't necessarily have to be long. I'm not against long songs, but they better be good if they're long. And when they're this short, it's just nice, short and sweet. Very good. I would say it's not my favorite of the set, but it's definitely good. It's definitely going on a playlist too, so. Like it, man. You're giving us some good shit. All right, so we are at the last song. Uh-oh. This might be the one song that I don't like. This is Shagahod, which is his friend, right? I think it's like your friend is in the band or was in the band or you grew up or went to high school with the guy. The couple of songs you've played on here definitely were not songs that people liked. And I didn't really dig them either. They were okay, but they weren't great or anything like that. This is called Widowmaker. And then in parentheses, it says, or tin, comma, golden lead or lead? Lead. I think it's lead. He says, and fuck it. I'm throwing more Shagahod at you. I'm legitimately blown away by the quality of this new album. This song has some really great melodic vocals. Cool. Some almost atmospheric low growls. I dig it a lot. These guys aren't part of Redemption to me, but I couldn't resist sticking this song here as well. Hope someone hears something that they liked. Well, we've heard a lot that we've liked. Let's see if we can finish off strong. I'm open to liking these dudes, but a couple times that we've heard them so far, I didn't dig them that much. So let's see if we can dig them now. Here we go. Last song of the night. Liking so far, it's very tribalish. Okay. I think maybe one of the reasons the other time wasn't as good is because the recording was bad, and I think that one was live, right? This sounds much better.
Just this, I never knew the word till you carved it in my kin. Helpless.
Good.
To trace a path to vengeance that was blistered in my skin. Brought to bear. Only to
nice
be
drums
spared.
There.
And be blooded on forever. Darkness, please.
Offbeat is good.
Throw your cloak of pity over me. Deep hell don't want me. Yeah, I'll make my case.
Interesting picture. A burning house.
Between the living and the dying, you know, so still in time.
I have a Tea Party song on my playlist. I think we heard one here, right? It was, I felt like it was very folky. wasn't heavy, if I remember correctly.
Mercy, wasted on the
wanted. Good bass line. Good fill.
Cause I take what I want. I want all I take. What does it matter to you?
Two, three.
If it wasn't your home, your blood, your chained hands.
I just remember the singer had like a Jesus hair and wasn't like goatee. Pretty cool. I do like the riffs in it. Definitely my favorite song by these guys for sure. I will definitely say that that was the best Shugahod, however you say it, song that we've had on here for me. Definitely a step up in recording, and just, I did like the writing. I thought it was good. It wasn't too kind of like, it wasn't like weird. It was kind of straightforward. It still left a little bit to be desired. I wouldn't say that I would necessarily put this on a playlist. It was definitely the weakest part of this set list, but it was good. I would say it was a good song. So yeah, man, that was Feedy. You're very, very keen on selling yourself short, which I think is a great, great way of, you know, selling yourself even better, because people expect to be disappointed, and then it turns out that these are great songs. So I would say 6 out of 6 for me, although 5 will go on a playlist. Probably not the last one, probably won't go on a playlist. Nothing stood out for me. But yeah, that was really good. So we are wrapping it up. Just reminder for you people, I'm trying now to not do Thursdays as much. I will do Thursdays if we have enough set lists that it calls, and it's just like so backed up that I need to like make sure we get through some of them. But as long as it is now, we are even as far as next week. So we have Saturday, Sunday, and Monday already. And that's it. No other set lists beyond that. So if you send in a set list tomorrow, today, the next day, it's going to be the following weekend. So just know that. Again, unless I get like 7 set lists in the next like 5 days, I'm not going to do Thursdays if possible, just to free up a day for me. But if we do get a lot of set lists, which we have at times, then I'll post it on a Thursday as well. So great time. You guys have a great start of your week as well, even though it's Monday. And we will see you guys on Saturday morning. Peace out. John, great job. Always love your sets. It's normal. I'm sure Adrian, he just got back from his trip to watch the poor Steelers get their asses beat, but that's okay. It happens. And he had to go do some other stuff, so he couldn't join. But I'm sure he'll watch this and he'll comment on the video. So peace out, people. We'll see you guys on Saturday. Later.